Hey everyone, Airbus Cockpit Coach here, and welcome to the channel. Today we're continuing our dive into the world of Airbus procedures with a specific focus on the Airbus Takeoff takeoff. We're here on stand in the Airbus 320 model by Fenix, the CEO, DFM engine variant. Before we get going, let's talk about the packs, a bit of a recap. So the packs are essentially the air conditioning system for the passenger cabin and the cockpit of the Airbus. They take the bleed air from the engines, they cool it down, and then distribute it throughout the aircraft. We've got two packs. The controllers for them are up here. So you've got PAX 1 and PAX 2. The Airbus has three air conditioning zones. First being the cockpit, which PAX 1 controls, and PAX 2 controls cabin zones. The back of the aircraft, beyond the cockpit. So you may be wondering why we'd want to do a Takeoff takeoff. And there's two main reasons for that. The first one is performance. So it's a Takeoff takeoff on hot days, high altitude airports, reduced engine thrust due to the bleed air feeding the packs can be a concern and reduce the aircraft's performance. Turning off the packs allows the engines to dedicate more power to takeoff. The second is engine life. Excessive use of bleed air during takeoff can contribute to higher exhaust gas temperatures, which can affect engine life. So a Takeoff takeoff would help mitigate that. We can feed the packs using the APU for takeoff. So if we're at a very high altitude aerodrome, with a high temperature, the cabin was stuffy, so we needed performance and also air conditioning. Leaving the APU on, as we have here, and the packs on for takeoff would mean that they're fed from the APU. So whenever the APU is on, it would feed the packs. The engines would have maximum thrust available with no air bleed coming off them for the packs in that case. So we can leave the APU on for takeoff, obviously a small fuel penalty for that, but that gives us full performance and a nice cabin environment maintained for the passengers. So the packs aren't always off for takeoff. It depends on airline standard operating procedures, and they're based on factors like airport conditions, temperature and altitude, the weight of the aircraft, the runway length and the condition of the runway on any particular day. Many airlines are also prioritising cabin ventilation, especially post-COVID pandemic, so packs on takeoff might be more common these days, although my operator has reverted to packs off as standard where possible. So that's back built back into our checklists. They're the main reasons why we'd, revert to using having the packs off for takeoff. Most airlines will include a check of the packs as part of their lineup checklist. Here we are at London Luton. We've just been cleared to line up and depart runway 25. Lineup checklist. Cabin secured, takeoff runway 25 confirmed, TCAS is TARA, and PAX 1 and 2 off. We need to allow 20 seconds between selecting the PAX off and selecting takeoff thrust to allow the valves to transition into place. Then continue our normal takeoff, and we'll have a look at when to turn the packs back on once we're airborne. So once airborne, we want to ensure we don't put the packs back on before thrust reduction altitude. Ensuring we've got a positive speed trend. Thrust climb, climb auto thrust. At this point, we'll turn our first pack back on. we'll wait 10 seconds before turning on pack 2. That's done to ensure passenger comfort is maintained. Turning both packs on at the same time can result in a lot of pressure coming into the cabin and a little bit painful on the ears at times. So there's 10 seconds. Pack 2 on. Yeah, we don't want to take bleed air from the engine during the initial climb out when we need that maximum thrust, so we generally wait till thrust reduction before re-engaging the packs. Should we fail to remember to turn the packs back on, there is an ECAM master caution that we'll get as we continue climb out with the packs off, and I can show you that now. So we've turned our packs back off and we're continuing the climb out. We would expect master caution shortly. Remind us, there we go. Master caution, air pack 1 off, pack 2 off. What do we need to do? Acknowledge that. Re-engage them. Waiting that 10 seconds between. Approximate 10 seconds. And pack 2 on. So that clears out the master caution and we can continue with the flight. So next time you're on the Airbus and you notice a change in airflow during takeoff, it most likely is due to the packs off procedure, which is all about optimizing performance and engine health while ensuring a safe and comfortable flight. Thanks for joining me today. If you have any questions about the packs off takeoff or anything else Airbus related, leave a comment below and I'll do my best to answer them. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more Airbus content, plenty more on the way, so stay tuned for that. Bye for now.